In this video, I'm going to name the best players in the NFL right now for each jersey number. Some numbers are more popular than others, and some numbers you probably won't care about, like offensive linemen or long snappers or whatever. But I'm going to cover it all anyway, because I'm a man of integrity, and that's what heroes do. Let's begin. Number 99, Aaron Donald, Los Angeles Rams. 2022 is the worst season of Donald's career, but when healthy, he is still the best defensive tackle in the league until further notice. Number 98, Max Crosby, Las Vegas Raiders. Sure, his name looks like a porn star's name, but this guy can play, constantly getting pressures. He's like one of only four good defensive players the Raiders have had over the last 30 years. Number 97, Nick Bosa, San Francisco 49ers. Say what you want about Bosa or his politics, but this guy is a monster, winning defensive player of the year in 2022. At the rate he's going to be a first ballot Hall of Famer as long as he can avoid injuries. Number 96, Danico Autry, Tennessee. Another one of the many NPC Titans players, Autry is solid, not great, but this is a pretty weak number. He's had 17 sacks over the last 2 years and has carved out a solid career for an undrafted player. Number 95, Myles Garrett, Cleveland Browns. It was close between Garrett and Chris Jones, but I give Garrett the edge because of a little more of a track record. And plus, he's still a dominant player right now anyway, racking up 16 sacks in each of the last two seasons, and he's also gone nearly three full years without almost killing somebody on the field. Number 94, Cameron Jordan, New Orleans Saints. It was close between Jordan and Washington's Daron Payne, but I gave it to Jordan based on his track record. He has 115 and a half career sacks and is still a Pro Bowl caliber player. Although in a year's time, Payne will probably have this spot secured. Number 93, Jonathan Allen, Washington. Allen is one of the best defensive tackles in the league, making the last two Pro Bowls and racking up 16 and a half sacks over the last two seasons. He's also extremely durable. See, Washington fans, at least one defensive lineman who went to Alabama will make this list, so don't get mad at me. Number 92, DaQuan Jones, Buffalo. Another one of those guys who has carved out a 10-year NFL career without ever really making a splash, but he's a solid player. He's also a product of the number 92 really not having any great players right now. But he's solid against the run, and you can never have a good enough defense. Number 91, Trey Hendrickson, Cincinnati Bengals. Hendrickson looks pregnant sometimes with his beer belly, and not too intimidating, but the guy can play. He's lived up to his contract since joining Cincinnati 2 years ago, racking up 22 sacks and making each of the last two Pro Bowls. Number 90, TJ Watt, Pittsburgh Steelers. Pretty easy choice here in each of Watt's last three healthy seasons. He was first team All-Pro and top three in Defensive Player of the Year voting, including winning the award in 2021 when he tied the single season record mark of 22 and a half sacks. As long as he stays healthy again, expect the same this year. Number 89, Mark Andrews, Baltimore Ravens. Andrews has made a Pro Bowl each of the last 2 years, including being named first team All-Pro in 2021. His numbers were down a bit last year, but he is smack dab in his prime, and he can be counted on to be one of Lamar Jackson's top receivers. But he'll never enjoy being a number two receiver as much as his new teammate, Odell Beckham Jr. Number 88, CeeDee Lamb, Dallas Cowboys. Lamb has gotten better every year of his three-year career, including racking up almost 1,400 yards and 9 touchdown catches last season while making second team All-Pro. Don't be shocked if he has one of the best seasons ever by a wide receiver to not make a conference championship game in 2023. Number 87, Travis Kelce. Clear-cut best tight end in the league, although some 49ers fans might have something to say about that. Kelce is arguably the greatest tight end ever, putting up unbelievable numbers as Patrick Mahomes' favorite target while the Chiefs are on the verge of becoming a dynasty. Pretty easy choice. Number 86, Zach Ertz, Arizona Cardinals. Ertz isn't as good as he once was in his heyday with the Eagles since joining the Cardinals a year and a half ago, but when healthy, he is still one of the better tight ends in the league. My wife also says he's really hot. Number 85, George Kittle, San Francisco 49ers. Probably the second best tight end in the league. In each of his last four healthy seasons, he's made the Pro Bowl. Last year, he caught 11 touchdowns while being a dominant blocker and being named second team All-Pro. A former fifth-round pick, he has turned out to be one of the biggest draft steals of all time. Number 84, Cordarrelle Patterson, Atlanta Falcons. Patterson has had an odd career. He was a first-round receiver bust with the Vikings, but he has ended up becoming the greatest kick returner in NFL history, and now he has molded his game to being an all-around jack-of-all-trades type player with the Falcons. Patterson really isn't that much different from Devin Hester, but unlike Hester, he's not going to get a lot of Hall of Fame consideration for whatever reason. I don't know. It's weird. Number 83, Tyler Boyd, Cincinnati Bengals. Boyd has carved out a very solid career as the best number three receiver in the league. He had back-to-back 1,000-yard seasons a couple years ago, and over the last 3 years has had around 800 yards and 40 4 to 5 touchdown catches. Joe Burrow is lucky to have him. Number 82, Logan Thomas, Washington. Thomas's breakout season in 2020 has been replicated over the last 2 years, but he's still a big body who can catch some passes. Another pretty weak number in the NFL. Number 81, Mike Williams, LA Chargers. By law, there must always be a receiver named Mike Williams in the NFL at all times. And this edition of Mike Williams is famous for his ability to snag jump balls out of the air. He has 2 1,000-yard seasons and averaged almost 70 yards a game last year as the Chargers' deep threat. Williams is a very solid player, and I know the Chargers have Justin Herbert now, but I think it gets overlooked that the Chargers could have drafted Mahomes 7th overall in 2017. Just think about that, please. Number 80, Isaiah Likely, Baltimore Ravens. Likely, as a rookie, showed some flashes as a deep threat for a tight end, but ultimately was very inconsistent. However, the number 80 isn't very strong in the league right now, and I do like his potential, so I gave him the nod over Denver's Greg Dulcich. I know most of you don't give a shit about offensive linemen, so I'm going to go through these numbers pretty quickly. Number 79, Akeem Ekwonu, Carolina Panthers. Ekwonu looks like an absolute stud at tackle and should be a linchpin among the Panthers' offensive line for many years to come. Number 78, Tristan Wirfs, Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Ever since Wirfs arrived on the scene in 2020, he has provided stability and excellence to the Buccaneers, helping their minimally talented quarterbacks look a lot better than they really are. Number 77, Frank Ragnow, Detroit Lions. When he's been healthy, he's consistently graded out as one of the best centers in the league. Easy choice. 76, Caleb McGarry, Atlanta Falcons. He's not a dominant player, but he has been a consistent right tackle and is a key part of the Falcons' running game under Arthur Smith. Number 75, Joel Bitonio, Cleveland Browns. He's made the last 5 Pro Bowls, been named first team All-Pro the last 2 years, and made All-Pro teams the last 5 years. Yeah, he's really good. 74, Elgton Jenkins, Green Bay Packers. Jenkins has made the Pro Bowl in each of his last 2 healthy seasons, and he's also extremely versatile along the offensive line, being able to play guard or tackle at a high level. Number 73, Deion Dawkins, Buffalo Bills. Dawkins has been a staple at left tackle for the Bills since 2017, and he has made the Pro Bowl in each of the last 2 seasons. Not bad. Number 72, Teron Armstead, Miami. Armstead is an incredible talent who has made 4 Pro Bowls, but he's never played a full season and is constantly rattled by injuries. That said, he still is the best number 72 the league has to offer at the moment. Number 71, Trent Williams. Williams has made 10 straight Pro Bowls and been named first team All-Pro each of the last 2 years. The only downside with Williams is that he has not played a full season since 2013 and is always due to miss a couple games every year. Number 70, Zach Martin, Dallas Cowboys. In his 9-year career, Martin has made 8 Pro Bowls and 6 first team All-Pro selections. Simply put, he's one of the best guards to ever play the game and will one day wind up in Canton despite never appearing in a conference championship game. Number 69, David Bakhtiari, Green Bay Packers. I almost wanted to give this to Landon Dickerson, but when Bakhtiari is active, which has been the problem with him over the last 3 years, he's still just as good as ever, although he's definitely on the downside of his career. Something tells me his next team will be the New York Jets. Number 68, Jordan Mailata, Philadelphia Eagles. A 2018 seventh round pick who didn't debut until 2020, Mailata looks like he will be a cornerstone on the Eagles line for the foreseeable future after a very, very promising 2022 season. Number 67, Charles Cross, Seattle Seahawks. The 9th overall pick in 2022 lived up to the hype, starting all 17 games at tackle for the Seahawks. His play most certainly helped rejuvenate Geno Smith's career. I wouldn't be shocked if he made the Pro Bowl this season. Number 66, Ryan Jensen, Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Jensen missed all of the regular season last year, and it was noticeable, as the offensive line lacked his typical nastiness that had helped the offense become so potent over the previous 3 years. Number 65, Lane Johnson, Philadelphia Eagles. Simply put, he's the best right tackle in the game, period. The problem is that he has health issues and seems to miss 1 to 3 games every year, but when he's on the field, there's nobody better, point blank, period. Number 64, Tyler Linderbaum, Baltimore Ravens. 25th overall pick in the 2022 draft showed that he was worth the hype, or about as much hype as a Baltimore Ravens offensive lineman can get. I think he'll have a very long and successful career, make a lot of Pro Bowls, and nobody will really notice because nobody really cares about offensive linemen except for the real sickos like me. Number 63, Chris Lindstrom, Atlanta Falcons. He might look like the Pillsbury Doughboy, but this second team All-Pro and Pro Bowler in 2022 is the best player on the Falcons offensive line and one of the best at what he does across the entire league. Number 62, Jason Kelce, Philadelphia Eagles. This is pretty self-explanatory. Jason Jason Kelce is not only the sexiest player in the NFL, he's also made 6 Pro Bowls, won a Super Bowl, and is a 5-time first-team All-Pro, including 5 of the last 6 years. Next, number 61, Mason Cole, Pittsburgh Steelers. A serviceable but not great player, his selection here really shows you just how little talent there is to wear number 61 in the NFL. Number 60, Mitch Morse, Buffalo Bills. He finally made his first Pro Bowl last year, the 8th season of his career, and he's been a consistent player at center for Josh Allen over the last several seasons. Number 59, Devondre Campbell. Campbell came out of nowhere in 2021 with Green Bay to be a first-team All-Pro member, and although he wasn't that good in 2022, he's still proven himself to be one of the better linebackers in the league in recent memory. Now that he's healthy again, expect a bounce-back year. Number 58, Matt Milano, Buffalo Bills. I almost went with Penei Sewell here, but Matt Milano is just so much sexier, and he's also a great player. Being named first-team All-Pro and a Pro Bowler in 2022, he is outstanding in pass coverage and really does everything well. Number 57, CJ Mosley, New York Jets. After appearing in just 2 games in his first 2 years with the Jets after leaving Baltimore, Mosley has responded over the last 2 years with a Pro Bowl selection and over 300 tackles. He was named second team All-Pro last season and is still just 31 years old. The 5-time Pro Bowler should have plenty left in the tank. Number 56, DeMario Davis, New Orleans Saints. Davis has quietly carved out a very, very good career, but the NFL is a what have you done for me lately league, and in each of the past 3 years, Davis has been a second team All-Pro, while he finally made his first Pro Bowl nod last year. He was also first team All-Pro in 2019 and has over 1,100 career tackles and 36 sacks. Number 55, Brandon Graham, Philadelphia Eagles. Even as an Eagles fan, I have to admit, Graham has had a very interesting career. He's made 1 Pro Bowl in 13 seasons, he was named second team All-Pro in 2016, and he has 70 career sacks, but 2022 was his first ever double-digit sack season. Yet despite this, he always seems to grade out well. Oh yeah, and he also made Tom Brady eat shit at the end of Super Bowl 52, which will always make him a Philadelphia legend. Thank you so much for everything you've done, Brandon. Number 54, Fred Warner, San Francisco 49ers. Arguably the best middle linebacker in the league, he's been named first team All-Pro in 2 of the last 3 seasons, and has racked up over 115 tackles in each of his 5 NFL seasons. He's also extremely durable, having missed just 1 game thus far in his career. Number 53, Shaquille Leonard, Indianapolis Colts. Better known as Darius Leonard, he appeared in only 3 games last year, which has kind of knocked some of the shine off of him, but in each of his last 2 healthy seasons, he was a first-team All-Pro selection, and he just turned 28 years old, so there's no reason to think that he can't bounce back and once again become a dominant player. Number 52, Creed Humphrey, Kansas City Chiefs. Khalil Mack isn't what he once was, so Creed Humphrey has accepted this honor with arms wide open, winning the Super Bowl in just his 2nd season, while also being named second team All-Pro. You know that with Creed on your team, he will take your offensive line higher, and even if he only has 1 last breath to give, he'll give it. Number 51, Azeez Ojulari, New York Giants. Azeez had 8 sacks in his rookie season in 2021, and had 5.5 in just 7 games last year during his injury-shortened sophomore year. When he's been on the field, simply put, the guy is really, really good. But as I say in every video, it doesn't matter in the big picture because Daniel Jones is his quarterback. Number 50, Vita Vea, Tampa Bay Buccaneers. He's a massive, fat, muscular blob that just fucks everything up for everybody. That's all you gotta know about Vita Vea. The Bucs defense is a lot more ferocious and tough to beat when he's in there. Number 49, Tremaine Edmonds, Chicago Bears. I've been on record saying Edmonds is overrated because of his large tackle totals and he's usually out of position, and that's all true, but he's still the best player to wear 49 because, I mean, really, who else wears 49? Congrats on your default selection. Number 48, Christian Harris, Houston Texans. Harris was one of the few bright spots for Houston in 2022. 3rd round pick out of Alabama, had an interception, a sack, and 74 tackles in just 12 games. He looks like he's going to be a solid player for many years to come and a potential building block for D'Amico Ryans on defense. Number 47, Josie Jewell, Denver Broncos. In his last 2 healthy seasons, he's had at least 113 tackles and 2 sacks. He's not necessarily great in coverage for a linebacker, but he's very good in between the tackles. And also, there's really nothing else for 47. Number 46, Morgan Cox, Tennessee Titans. Morgan Cox has made 5 Pro Bowls, he's won a Super Bowl, and he's been named first team All-Pro. And you don't even know who he is, do you? You know why? Because he's a long snapper. And long snappers are the invisible men of the NFL. All this guy does, year after year, game after game, essentially snap the ball back to the holder for the kicker to kick through the uprights. Somebody, me, needs to do a show about long snappers. It's about time time long snappers got some love, damn it. Number 45, Devin White, Tampa Bay Buccaneers. White is one of the most polarizing players in the league because his highlight reel is insane, but he's also not very smart and he misses a lot of tackles and he's out of position a lot. But he's such an athletic freak that he will continue to get chance after chance, and he's still only 25 years old. Number 44, Marlon Humphrey, Baltimore Ravens. Humphrey has made 3 Pro Bowls and 1 first team All-Pro over the last 4 seasons. He's become a little bit more well-known for Twitter than his play on the field, but he has been the glue keeping that secondary together in recent memory. Also, to his sister, so. Number 43, Michael Davis, LA Chargers. Davis has been a solid player for years for the Chargers, although he did get a pick 6 off of Tom Brady back in 2020, so I like the guy, even if the Chargers lost that game. Number 42, Patrick Ricard, Baltimore Ravens. Ricard is a multi-time Pro Bowler and one of the few fullbacks left in the NFL. He's also an incredible tweeter. Just go ahead and look it up for yourself. But anyway, his blocking makes a lot of what the Ravens do on the ground possible. Number 41, Josh Allen, Jacksonville Jaguars. Hey, did you know that there's another Josh Allen besides the Bills quarterback in the NFL? Wow! Anyway, yeah, Josh Allen, solid player, has become a vital part of the Jaguars defense. Still maybe not quite as good as the Jaguars had hoped when they picked him a couple years back, but respectable player nonetheless. Number 40, Von Miller, Buffalo Bills. Miller isn't what he once was during his heyday when he was carrying Peyton Manning to Super Bowls in Denver, but he's still a very, very good defensive end. It's unfortunate his first year in Buffalo was cut short, but if he's healthy, I still believe he has another great season or two left in him, making this an easy choice. Number 39, Minkah Fitzpatrick, Pittsburgh Steelers. In 3.5 seasons with Pittsburgh, Fitzpatrick has made 3 Pro Bowls and 3 first-team All-Pro selections. He also led the league in interceptions last year with 6. It seems the Dolphins erred in letting him go too soon. Number 38, Ramondre Stevenson, New England Patriots. Stevenson might be the best offensive player for the Patriots, which is both good and bad for their current situation. He averaged 5 yards a carry last year, while also showing to be a capable pass catcher. His one bugaboo was 4 fumbles, but what are you going to do? Nobody's perfect, except me. Number 37, Amani Hooker, no offense to women who use OnlyFans, Tennessee Titans. Kevin Byard is the best secondary member of the Titans, but Hooker is solid, but not much more than that. His selection goes to show you how weak the number 37 is in the league. Number 36, Jasir Taylor, LA Chargers. 6th-round pick in 2022, had no interceptions, no sacks, and just 22 tackles in his rookie year last year. And yeah, the number 36, not very strong. Number 35, Gus Edwards, Baltimore Ravens. Oh, Gus, if he could ever just stay healthy and get a full-time role. In each of his 4 seasons that he's played, he's averaged over 5 yards to carry. Unfortunately, he's not very durable, but fortunately for him, there aren't too many good number 35s in the league right now, so he gets the nod. Number 34, Jalen Thompson, Arizona Cardinals. In his 4 years with Arizona, Thompson has racked up 5 interceptions and made a bunch of tackles over the last 2 seasons, over 230 to be exact, but that's not always a good thing when you're a cornerback. His passer rating against is also not very good, but he's the best of the lot to wear number 34 right now. Number 33, Aaron Jones, Green Bay Packers. The versatile all-around back should get even more touches than he does, and I think he will, but who knows? I'm not the coach in Green Bay, nor am I as handsome as the coach in Green Bay, Matt LaFleur. Just don't ask Jones to hold on to the ball in a crucial moment. Number 32, Tyrann Mathieu, New Orleans Saints. The 3-time Pro Bowler and 3-time All-Pro, as well as Super Bowl champion, had a solid, if unspectacular, debut season with his hometown Saints. He's still young enough, 31 years old, to think there's no reason why he can't bounce back to his Kansas City level, but I guess we'll have to wait now, won't we? Number 31, Kevin Byard, Tennessee Titans. The best 2-time first team All-Pro that nobody has ever heard about or cares about. Kevin was first team All-Pro in 2017 and 2021, but has no other personal accolades in any other seasons of his career, despite being a relatively consistent performer in pass coverage outside of 2020. Very odd what's going on there. Number 30, Austin Eckler, LA Chargers. Eckler is not a great pure runner, but he's another one of these versatile all-around backs who catches a lot of short passes out of the backfield and also vultures a lot of touchdowns around the goal line. He's a better fantasy player than he is a real player, but he's still a good real player. Number 29, Talanoa Hufanga, San Francisco 49ers. Hoof was drafted in the fifth round in 2021 and after a nondescript rookie season, broke out last year to become a first-team All-Pro safety. You won't believe this, but he gets Troy Polamalu comparisons because people are just so smart. I don't know if he's as good as Polamalu, but he still is really good. Did you know they both went to USC? Wow. Number 28, Josh Jacobs, Las Vegas Raiders. Jacobs was the best running back in the league last season with Derrick Henry getting hurt, deservedly making All-Pro honors. In a vacuum, I still don't think he's as good as Nick Chubb, but he is certainly an elite back, at least for now. Not much discussion here. Number 27, Tariq Woolen, Seattle Seahawks. Reek the Freak, as he's known, was tied for the league as a rookie with 6 interceptions. He finished 3rd in Defensive Rookie of the Year voting and made the Pro Bowl while having a stellar 48.7 passer rating against. He looks like a stud for the foreseeable future. 26, Saquon Barkley, New York Giants. Barkley has been a big name running back since entering the league out of Penn State 5 years ago, but injuries and some coaching decisions have prevented him from truly becoming the best running back in the league like everybody thought he would be. He's still a great player when healthy, but when healthy is the key part. Number 25, Xavien Howard, Miami Dolphins. Howard has twice led the league in interceptions and has made 4 Pro Bowls and a first team All-Pro, including making the Pro Bowl in each of the last 3 seasons. He's a bit of a gambler in terms of defensive backs go, but he is a very good player and a key to the Dolphins defense. 24, Nick Chubb, Cleveland Browns. Simply put, Nick Chubb is the best running back in the NFL. In 5 seasons, he's never had a yards per attempt lower than 5. He's a capable pass catcher out of the backfield if they were able to throw to him more. He does well in pass protection and he's just consistent. Outside of Derrick Henry, if there was one active running back who I think could end up in the Hall of Fame someday, it's Chubb. Number 23, Jair Alexander, Green Bay Packers. Whenever Alexander's been healthy recently, he has been a lockdown player, making 2 Pro Bowls in each of the last 2 healthy seasons he's played. And he also picked off Tom Brady twice in the fourth quarter of the 2020 NFC Championship game, which is a game the Packers should have won, goddammit. It's only a matter of time before he makes a couple first-team All-Pro teams. Number 22, Derrick Henry, Tennessee Titans. Over the last 4 seasons, Derrick Henry has averaged 109.9 yards per game on the ground at a 4.8 yards per attempt clip. He also averages 9.9 yards per reception and is great in pass protection. A throwback great who would thrive in any era of football. Number 21, Jordan Poyer, Buffalo Bills. Just because Jordan Poyer looks like Steph Curry doesn't mean that he's as good as Steph Curry is at basketball, but he still is pretty good at what he does, although his wife is a bit of an annoying bitch. No offense. First team All-Pro in 2021 and a Pro Bowler last year. He's right in the middle of his prime right now, so I expect another good year in 2023. Number 20, Tony Pollard, Dallas Cowboys. Zeke's sidekick over the last several seasons now has the reins all to himself, and I believe he has the ability to do more than Zeke ever did if he can stay healthy. I truly believe he could have one of the greatest seasons of any running back ever to never make the conference championship game this year. And I know what you're thinking. You're saying, oh God, he does that conference championship game joke every video. Yeah, because it's fucking funny and true, and it's ridiculous that the fucking Dallas Cowboys get to be on TV 8 times a year nationally, despite having 3 fewer conference championship game appearances than the fucking Jaguars since Tupac was shot, okay? It's fucking ridiculous. Fuck the Cowboys. I will never fail to bring up their postseason failures since 1996. Moving on. Number 19, Deebo Samuel, San Francisco 49ers. Is Deebo a wide receiver? Is he a running back? It doesn't matter. He is an impactful player and quite easily the best number 19 in the NFL right now, although I would like to see him be more of a receiver. No offense to Adam 22's wife. Number 18, Justin Jefferson, Minnesota Vikings. Pretty simple. The guy had over 1,800 receiving yards last season, and although I still think he should score more touchdowns than he does, double teams in the red zone be damned, he still is one of the top 2 or 3 receivers in the NFL right now. Easy choice. Number 17, Devontae Adams, Las Vegas Raiders. This is one of the very few difficult number selections because obviously Josh Allen also wears number 17 for the Bills, and he's one of the best quarterbacks in the league, but this was not value. This was strictly the best player, and I think Devontae Adams is the best receiver in the league and a future Hall of Famer, so I went with Devontae. Not to brag, but I'm pretty sure I just ended racism. You're welcome. Number 16, Trevor Lawrence, Jacksonville Jaguars. I'd like to think Lawrence has turned the corner for good to finally start living up to his incredible hype coming out of Clemson, so I'm going to put him here, but I still want to see another good half season out of him before I fully buy in. Number 15, Patrick Mahomes, Kansas City Chiefs. He's Patrick fucking Mahomes. What else do I have have to say. Number 14, Stephon Diggs. One of the best receivers in the league, especially since he got to Buffalo 3 years ago. Legend has it he's still standing on the Arrowhead field looking at the Chiefs celebrating their AFC championship. Number 13, Mike Evans, Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Evans has had 1,000 yards in each of his first 9 seasons and is an incredible red zone threat. With him, it's all about health. If he can stay healthy and on the field, he's going to produce no matter how bad his quarterbacks are. And for the first time since 2019, he finally has a good quarterback again. Number 12, Tom Brady. Oh, shit. He retired. Never mind. Aaron Rodgers. Nah, fuck. He changed to number 8. Now, who's the number 12 I can use here? Oh, let's see. You know, Pro Football Reference. Oh, Chris Olave. Yes, New Orleans. Chris Olave. His stellar 1,000-yard rookie season. Looks like a future stud. It's not a first-bout Hall of Fame quarterback number anymore, but you have to make do with what you got. Number 11, Micah Parsons, Dallas Cowboys. The biggest fucking weirdo in the league, outside of Deshaun Watson. Parsons is an absolute game wrecker, and he is so dominant, he's able to carry his team to the divisional round every season before they lose. Number 10, Tyreek Hill, Miami Dolphins. To me, he's the second best receiver in the NFL right now. His speed completely changes game plans, and he also has a major impact on his wife and children. I didn't say a good impact, but he certainly has an impact. Number 9, Joe Burrow. I don't understand all the gene creaming by women over Joe Burrow because he looks like Macaulay Culkin to me, but as a quarterback, he's amazing in the regular season and extremely overrated in the playoffs. Yet, he's still one of the best the NFL has, so he deserves to be in this spot. Number 8, Aaron Rodgers, New York Jets. I almost went with Lamar Jackson before switching to Rodgers just because I think Rodgers is going to have a bounce back season and actually give a shit again, because most of last year he looked like he was just going through the motion. But be warned, Jets fans, Rodgers will make you believe and then at the last second completely rip your heart out by playing like shit in the fourth quarter of the biggest games. Number 7, Trevon Diggs, Dallas Cowboys. A bit of an all or nothing cornerback, much like Asante Samuel or Marcus Peters, but when he hits, he hits. And in today's NFL, with so many rules neutering defenses, it's really all about turnovers, and Diggs generates a lot of turnovers. Is he overrated? I don't know, but I do know that he won't make the conference championship game this year. Number 6, Devonta Smith, Philadelphia Eagles. Smith is so skinny, if you open a door next to him, he'll fly out of it, but the guy can play. With incredible footwork, he's only getting better, and I expect him and A.J. Brown to be the best wide receiver duo in the league this year. And once you throw in Dallas Goedert, I expect them to be the best receiving core in the league this year, bar none. Number 5, Jalen Ramsey, Miami Dolphins. Ramsey has bounced around a little too much for my liking for such a great player, but now that he's hurt in Miami and might miss the start of the season, I do think his value will be seen pretty quickly. When healthy, he is still one of the top cornerbacks in the league, although he is getting a bit up in age now and might not be the force he was a couple years ago. Number 4, Dak Prescott, Dallas Cowboys. Dak is a good quarterback, but much like his predecessor Tony Romo, he's just not a guy who you can really trust in the biggest of the big moments, despite his stats. And honestly, I don't even know if his teammates respect him because they're out here calling him bitch and all these other derogatory terms. I'm just saying, if your teammates are calling you, the team's quarterback, a bitch, they don't think they can win a Super Bowl with you. Number 3, Russell Wilson, Denver Broncos. I think it was very smart and clever of Sean Payton to take the pressure off of Wilson heading into the season by saying a bunch of dumb shit in the media to distract them. I think overall, Wilson will get back to his previous form. I mean, Jesus, if he does not do well with Sean Payton, he might as well just quit football and become Sierra's husband full-time. Number 2, Patrick Surtain II, Denver Broncos. Because his initials spell out PS2, and that's a very nostalgic childhood memory of mine where I have wasted a lot of hours of my life playing games on there, Surtain gets the spot. Not because he's a great football player. Number 1, Jalen Hurts, Philadelphia Eagles. He should have won Super Bowl 57 last season, but came up just short thanks to his defense playing like crap and the sod father and Carl Sheffers, but that's neither here nor there. He's going to win the Super Bowl this year, so you might as well just get used to it now, because I'm going to say it every single week. And finally, number 0, Roquan Smith, Baltimore Ravens. As of right now, I don't have any photos of Smith wearing a 0 Ravens jersey, so I had to go and get this stock picture of it. Smith's a very good player, makes a lot of hits, good linebacker. Just do not Google Roquan Smith, South Africa. Believe me. Here is the list in full for all of you to digest, and in a short bit, I will flip to teams who had the most players make the list. At least one player from all 32 teams made it. Baltimore and Buffalo led the way with 7. Dallas, Philly, San Fran all had 6. Green Bay, Tampa Bay, Tennessee had 5. Chargers, Dolphins, Saints had 4. Then you had a bunch with 3. Surprisingly, Kansas City City only had three, but two of the three that they had are the very best at their important positions, quarterback and tight end in the entire league. You add some twos and then ones, which are really not that surprising.